हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट टू डिस्कस अबाउट ब्रिटिश ट्रेड इन बंगाल। सी, वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट डिफरेंट यूरोपियन कम्युनिटीज केम टू इंडिया, दे सेटल्ड, दे एस्टैब्लिश्ड, ऑल्सो विद इन देम देयर वॉज क्लैश। And in that clash, Britishers became more successful. We have already studied about all this, right? Now, we have to understand one thing, that how the British trade reached to Bengal. See, in India, there is a big opportunity for any company in those days and in today to create the market. As well as India was a big place for getting commodities in as much as low prices. Remember this word. So they can get profit from purchasing goods in India at lowest price and selling goods in their countries at the highest price, right? Okay, now listen carefully. So the Britishers started their trade first in Gujarat, Surat. Then they reached to Mumbai. But in time of Shah Jahan, they got first permission to start a trade. The Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan, I am saying the name, in his time they started to do trade in that area of Bengal after getting permission. But that permission was with paying tax in Bengal to trade, right? See, every word which I am speaking is important. What I have said, Shah Jahan gave permission to start trade. But for that trade, they had to pay tax in Bengal. Right? But now, as I am talking, after the death of Shah Jahan, as the Aurangzeb came to the throne as the Mughal Emperor in India, he gave a permission to Britishers to do trade without paying tax in Bengal, but instead of that, they have to do annual payment direct in Delhi, right, to himself. Means Britishers has not to pay tax regularly in Bengal, but they have to pay directly one time payment to the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb in Delhi, right? So here only one person was losing the tax, and he was Subedar of Bengal, the representative of Mughal Emperor in Bengal. But Shah Jahan was already getting money, so there is no problem about Shah Jahan's own income. It was safe, right? So now you remember one thing. In this situation, neither any person may agree with this, actually. Because see, the Subedar in Bengal was the representative of Mughal Emperor. So he has to regularly submit the payment, and what tax he collect, some specific amount remain with him for maintenance of his army and so other stuff. But here the money directly going to the Mughal Emperor in Delhi, so the amount of Subedar was not going to him. That is the loss to the Subedar. So he was not agree with this. Okay. But on other side, Britishers were earning now money in lots more. And in that case, Britishers had opportunity to do trade tax free in Bengal. But again I say, Mughal Emperor was already getting money, only Subedar was losing, right? On other side, on name of company, whatever the commodities were purchased by Britisher from India were going to Britain. Listen, I am saying again this line. The commodities Britishers were purchasing from India by name of East India Company. But actually what was this? Private purchase of British East India Company's officer on name of company, it was going to Britain, but actually it was purchased commodity for officers privately. So here company was losing, because when the ship will reach to Britain, the goods will brought to the port, will go to the residence of the officer personally. So here officer is free of tax purchasing goods, and company is paying tax to the Mughal Emperor, but officer is not having any burden of tax on himself. So in that situation, company was losing on one side, Bengal Subedar was losing on other side. So here I could say British officer were doing their private trade on name of East India Company. That was not good. So actually it was loss to two persons. First is a company and second is a Subedar of Bengal. So in that situation, now listen carefully. Subedar of Bengal, Murshid Kuli Khan, was not agree with the order of Aurangzeb to allow Britishers to do trade tax free in Bengal. In that situation, the dispute arose between Subedar of Bengal and Mughal Emperor. After death of Murshid Kuli Khan, when the Aliwardi Khan came to the power, he also opposed this order. And after him, his grandson, actually in your book it is said his son, but actually in really, after Aliwardi Khan, his grandson came to the power, Siraj ud Daula. He was very young, he was very aggressive. So in that situation he opposed the order, and he insisted Britishers to pay tax compulsorily. And in that situation there was a major battle erupt between Sirajuddola and Britisher. So you understand one thing, there was a reason of clash between Sirajuddola and Britisher. Now the reason of paying tax is asked by Sirajuddola and Britisher were denying. Denying means were not ready to pay tax just by the order of Aurangzeb. So here this was a reason of clash between Sirajuddola and Britishers. Okay, now here I discuss about the situation of paying tax, not paying tax, so many things. So here the base is clear about clash between Bengal and British East India Company, right? So now we are discussing the next question is Battle of Plassey, the most important question in your book, right, of the first term. Very most important question I'm going to start. Okay, my friends.